Good morning, students. We'll continue the lesson Language of Chemistry, Class 8. In the previous class, I explained you how to balance the chemical equation by following the law of conservation of mass, and you all know law of conservation of mass states that matter is neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction, or mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. Now here we can explain the law of conservation of mass by taking some few equations. Like here I have written calcium plus hydrochloric acid gives calcium chloride plus hydrogen. Now if we see that whether this equation is following the law of conservation of mass, so for that we have to see the mass of each element and calculate the total mass of the reactant with the total mass of the product. So here we can say that calcium has mass 40 gram, hydrogen has mass 1 gram and chlorine has mass 35.5 gram. Now in the reactant, first we will look at the reactant. What is the reactant? The reactant elements are calcium and hydrochloric acid. So calcium and hydrochloric acid means calcium has mass 40 and hydrochloric acid has mass, means it has two elements, hydrogen and chlorine. So hydrogen has mass 1 and chlorine has mass 35.5. So we total both the hydrogen, mass of the hydrogen and chlorine, that is 1 plus 35.5, and we have to add it with the mass of the calcium, that is 40. So total will be 76.5 gram. That is the mass of the calcium as well as the hydrochloric acid, means the mass of the reactant is 76.5 gram. Now we will look at the right hand side, that is the product side, what the products are formed in this equation. So here the products are calcium chloride and hydrogen. So calcium chloride, here also we will see the mass of both the calcium chloride and hydrogen. So the mass of calcium chloride is, we know that mass of calcium is 40 gram and here chlorine is 35.5 gram. So what will happen, 40 plus 35.5 into 2, because chlorine has 2 atoms. So 35.5 into 2 will multiply and then will add with the mass of the calcium, that is 40 gram. So total will be 111 gram. That is the mass of the calcium chloride. Now here the second product is also there, that is the hydrogen H2. And we know that the mass of the hydrogen is 1 gram. So 1 into 2 means 2. 2 gram will be the mass of the hydrogen. But if here the products are calcium chloride as well as hydrogen, means the mass of the calcium chloride is 111 gram and mass of the hydrogen is 2 gram. So 111 plus 2 is equal to 113 gram. But here in the reactant side, what we have seen, that the mass of the calcium and hydrochloric acid was 76.5 gram. So here we see that it is not following the law of conservation of mass, because the mass of the reactant is not equal to mass of the product. So what will happen, we have to balance the equation, then only we will get the mass of the reactant will be equal to mass of the product, or we can say that it will follow the law of conservation of mass. So what we have to do, we have to change the equation. Now how will change? Calcium plus HCl, that is we have to multiply the hydrochloric acid by 2, and then only we will get calcium chloride, that is CaCl2, and hydrogen H2. So here what will happen, calcium has mass 40, I have already told you, and hydrochloric acid the mass is hydrogen, means it will be multiplied by 2, means the mass of hydrogen is 1. So it will be multiplied by 2, means 2. 2 will be the mass of the hydrogen, and chlorine also has 2 atoms, means, and the mass of the chlorine is 35.5, and 2 it will be multiplied by 2, means it will be total mass of the hydrochloric acid will be 73 if you multiply it with 2. So what will happen, 40 plus 73, 40 is the mass of calcium and 73 is the mass of hydrochloric acid. So total will be 113 gram of the reactant. Now here we can see the product also in the right hand side. Here the calcium chloride, means mass of the calcium is 40, we all know, and chlorine is 35.5, but we have to multiply it with 2, Cl2 it is there, so 35.5 into 2. So when we calculate the 40 plus 35.5 into 2, we will get 111 ग्राम. नाउ हियर हाइड्रोजन इज ऑल्सो देयर. हाइड्रोजन द मास ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इज 1 एंड 2 एटम इज देयर मीन्स 1 × 2 मीन्स 2 ग्राम ऑफ मास विल बी देयर ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन मॉलिक्यूल. सो टोटल इफ वी एड 111 ऑफ द कैल्शियम क्लोराइड एंड 2 मास ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन देन टोटल विल बी 113 ग्राम. So what we can see that here we see that the mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. Now this equation will follow the law of conservation of mass, because law of conservation of mass state that mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. So this is all about how to balance the equation and how it will follow the law of conservation of mass. Now by looking at the equation, what we get the information? We get the information, just now I have written this equation, Ca plus HCl gives CaCl2 plus H2. So here the reactant is there. तो सबसे पहले आपको देखना है कि जो रिएक्टेंट होते हैं कौन कौन से हैं. तो क्या रिएक्टेंट है? कैल्शियम और हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड. अब यहाँ पे देखना है कि आपको प्रोडक्ट क्या क्या है, क्या क्या प्रोडक्ट बन रहा है. तो प्रोडक्ट आर कैल्शियम क्लोराइड एंड हाइड्रोजन. So these are the product and this is the reactant. Now this is the first thing we have to see in the chemical equation, that what are the reactants which are combining together and what are the products which are formed as a result of the chemical reaction. Now second thing we have to see the mass of the reactant as well as the mass of the product. So here the mass of the reactant in the first equation we got that 76.5 gram mass. But the product, the mass is 113 gram, so it is not following the law of conservation of mass. So here we have to see what are the mass of different elements, and if they are not following the law of conservation of mass, means the equation is not properly balanced, and we have to balance the equation by multiplying with the number, or we have to change the equation slightly so that they can follow the law of conservation of mass. So mass of the reactant, as in the equation, calcium has 40 mass, hydrogen has mass 1, chlorine has 35.5. So these are the mass of the reactants. And what will be the mass of the product? The same thing, whatever the product which are formed, each element we have to take out the mass. Calcium has 40 mass, 40 gram, mass of the chlorine is 35.5 and mass of the hydrogen is 1. So and number of atom if they have, we have to multiply. So these are all about the what are the information we are gathering from the chemical equation. Like here we can say one equation I have written, sodium plus chlorine gives sodium chloride. So sodium has mass 23 and chlorine has mass 35.5. Means we have to simply add both. So these are the reactants, sodium and chlorine. So 23 plus 35.5 means 58.5 gram will be the mass of the sodium as well as chlorine, that is the mass of the reactant. Now we will see the mass of the product, that is sodium chloride. So sodium also has mass 23, just now I told, and the chlorine has 35.5. Simply add, we can get 58.5 gram. So here they are following the law of conservation of mass, means mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. So in the same way we can take some another example also. How we can take the example of the calcium chloride gives on heating gives calcium oxide and oxygen, like CaCO3, calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate gives calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So here also same thing we have to follow. Mass of calcium is 40 gram plus mass of carbon is 12 and mass of oxygen is 16, but here 3 atoms are there, so we have to multiply it with 3. Now these are the reactant. Now how first we will calculate the mass of the reactant. So here 40 plus 12 plus 16, 3 is 48. So 16, 3 is 48, and here total if we add the mass of the reactant, that is calcium carbonate, it will be 8, 9, 10, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, means 100 gram. So 100 gram will be the mass of the reactant. Because here we are simply calculating the molecular mass. Molecular mass of calcium, that is the atomic mass of calcium, is 40, carbon is 12 and oxygen is 16. But here 3 atoms are there, so we have to multiply by 16 into 3, and when we calculate this, we'll get the 100 gram of the reactant of both that is calcium carbonate. In the same way, here we'll look at the product also. Product is what? The calcium oxide. Calcium oxide means calcium has mass 40 gram and oxygen has mass 16 gram. So 40 plus 16 means 56 gram of calcium oxide is formed. And carbon dioxide has mass, carbon has mass 12 and oxygen has 16 into 2. So 12 plus 16, 2 is 32. So 32 and 12 means 44 gram. So 56 per 44 gram you get, means if 56 is the gram of the calcium oxide and 44 will be the gram of the carbon dioxide. So when we add both 56 and 44, we will get 100 gram. So here what we can say, the mass of the reactant, that is also 100 gram, and mass of the product is also 100 gram. Means here it is following the law of conservation of mass, that is mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. So this is called law of conservation of mass, that is matter is neither created nor destroyed in the chemical equation. So this is all about the law of conservation of mass. And today I will give some numerical problems regarding this.